Said if we were in high school, I'd take him behind the gym and beat the hell out of him.
I'd like to punch him in the face.
When was the last time an actor assassinated a president?
Is fight in Congress, fight in the courts, fight in the streets, fight online, fight at the ballot box.
I just don't even know why there aren't uprisings all over the country. Maybe there will be.
Show me where it says that protests are supposed to be polite and peaceful.
When they go low, we kick them.
You know, there needs to be unrest in the streets for as long as there's unrest in our lives.
Biggest terror threat in this country is white men, most of them radicalized right up to the right.
I have thought an awful lot about blowing up the White House.
Enemies of the state.
And if you see anybody from that cabinet in a restaurant, in a department store, at a gasoline station, you get out and you create a crowd. And you push back on them, and you tell them they're not welcome anymore, anywhere.
And sadly, the domestic enemies to our voting system and our honoring our Constitution are right at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue.
I will go and take Trump out tonight.
Interesting to me. To see Democrats who once disparaged, who ignored the violence, I should say, all of a sudden caring about it. But let's not forget what they said previously. Speaker Nancy Pelosi downplaying the violence rocking U.S. cities, ignorantly saying people will do what they do. Jerry Nadler, when asked about Antifa, he said that was a myth that's being spread around Washington, D.C. It's not a myth. In fact, an Antifa individual took the life of an innocent Trump supporter in Portland. You have Rep. Ayanna Pressley saying that she wanted unrest in the streets. Chris Cuomo saying, show me where it says protesters are supposed to be peaceful. I'll give you an idea, Chris, it's the Constitution. Don Lemon saying, quote, the rioting has to stop, Chris, as you know. And I know it's showing up in the polls, it's showing up in the focus groups. It's the only thing right now that's sticking. So now all of a sudden, 90 days later, I from this podium have talked about law and order. The president has talked about law and order repeatedly, but because the polling has shifted, now it's time for the Democrats to deny what they said previously and all of a sudden focus on law and order. I'll leave you with this. That's like the arsonist blaming the firefighter.